love it and it works for me. Old fashioned is good.
It's
I'm
good.
Okay with that.
It's
I'm
good.
Okay
that. You brought okay. it back in a modern way.
Yeah, this cute little app when I was looking for apps. When this one came up, I said, oh my god, it was meant for me.
It's good. Here,
all right.
Here, let's show everybody.
So this is my interviewing app. Now the secret's out. Okay.
I'm sorry, did I give it away? I'm
yeah,
sorry.
It's okay. We're good.
You can delete that. Edit.
All right, so now we're very lucky at Carolyn Talk to Talk to get to interview
yes.
Marie Wilson.
This is fun. Thank you.
I am a huge fan of and a friend of, which is really lovely. First question right off the bat.
Okay. All right.
What inspired you and when did you decide to become an actor?
I didn't decide on a date. Do I talk to the camera or did I talk to you? It just happened. I fell into it. I was bored one summer. All my friends were doing stuff and I had nothing to do. And my mom suggested, hey, let's do a fun makeover class at John Casablancas studio. So I went and just did fun learning how to do makeup and dressing up. And then the agency saw me there and I started modeling. They took me on and the modeling led to commercials and commercials led to TV and film and here I am.
So then what became your first role beyond the modeling? What was your first role in TV or film?
My first role was the Sonny and Cher, The Beat Goes On. I played Mary Bono.
I was going to say, you played
yes.
Sonny Bono's wife, didn't
yes.
you?
Yes.
Oh my god,
pregnant.
Second wife, yeah.
Pregnant in the movie, yeah. So it was fun. It was kind of weird being pregnant at the time.
How old were you? I mean, just
I don't know.
Was that a long time ago? I mean, that was you were very young then.
Yes.
Because I remember the movie.
Oh, you do?
Yes, I was a huge fan. I'm a Cher fan, so
okay.
I was a...
Wasn't she awesome? She nailed Cher. She was so great. She was...
It was amazing.
It was really amazing. Well.
Yeah, it was really
yeah.
good.
Yeah.
And I remember thinking, wow, this is like a great story, and they did it well. And I remember seeing you in it and thinking, I had seen, actually, Mary Bono once.
Oh,
thinking,
really?
Wow, they really did a nice Mary Bono here. They gave her a real present by having somebody special doing her. Because I had, and I didn't know who you were back then. I thought, oh my gosh.
See? 6 degrees of separation.
There you go. In my mind, it's always three.
All three. We could change
always, it. You could always figure it out somehow to make it three. I've yet to find it to go all the way to six. That's a real hard reach. It's
three's
really
good.
Cool.
Three's good.
I'm
we'll
good.
Go
I'm good with that. So then, after that, did you then... very quickly transition into soap operas? Because I know that you have ended up on several soap operas, starting with, you know,
yeah.
General Hospital. Was
after,
that it?
After that, I think, I don't remember the exact time span, but I went in to audition for Port Charles and got it. So I replaced the first Karen Wexler that was on
okay.
the show. So, but it was a great transition and everybody was great because it was a new show and everybody was excited and pumped up and it was a lot of great energy. So,
yeah, that show should have lasted longer, but
you know, it was great. Everybody just had a great energy and everybody just had, I think we started the whole vampire thing. The whole vampire stories and all that, you know,
I think
that
people
concept.
Who- like me, who remember Dark Shadows, got a kick out of it,
yeah,
I have to admit.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Because it was so different than what daytime soaps were doing.
Yep. It was cutting edge.
It was fun. unfortunately, the people who needed to watch it, there wasn't as many, but yeah. I think everybody who watched it loved it.
Loved it. Yeah.
I mean, there was a disappointment in the air when it disappeared.
Yeah.
Without question. Now, then from there you went on to As the World Turns.
As the World Turns, and that was shot in New York, so I flew back and forth every week because my family was still here.
Now,
so,
when, at this point, was your daughter already born at this point?
Yes.
Okay.
She was 4 years old.
Okay.
So that was really hard. That was really hard. But I brought her back east with me during the summertime, and she did summer camp, and she saw her family and hung out.
Oh, so that's good.
Yeah, we went to Broadway plays. It was fun. It was like a little girl day summer.
Now, did she really appreciate what was happening, that she was getting to have this special trip?
I think she's had such great memories that she wants to actually go to NYU now for college. So yeah, that's her place.
Oh, that's wonderful. It's a great school.
I know I keep hearing that, yes, so I'm excited. Yes, yes. I'm excited. And I get to visit.
Yeah. Extended visits,
yes.
Really good.
Yes.
You know?
Yeah.
Maybe book something there. Even better.
I'll move back. Who knows?
Now, when you got, I have to ask you about this, on As the World Turns. When you found out the depth of your character, Meg Snyder.
Yes.
And her cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs behavior. How did that hit you? Like, were you like, oh, this is great? Or were you like, okay, now I gotta make sure I do this right? Where were you in that?
I wanna make sure I'm as truthful to the character and that she's coming from the right place. Cause not everybody is just crazy. It comes from somewhere. And I think for her, it came from just being desperate and just trying to prove herself and nobody believing her. So I think she was desperate and did a lot of desperate, crazy things. So, you know, I needed to justify it and not make her just crazy, just more of a truthful, she was coming from a more truthful place.
Now, I follow that show. And I watched the evolution of the character and how she would go from those wonderful moments of being completely lucid. Were you coached? Did you study anything at that point? Because you did those so seamlessly, where it seemed like it was really the evolution, the working her way into the panic and then the fear and then the lunacy once again, because she did go up and down during that series, and it really seemed natural, like that was really happening, as opposed to they're manipulating a storyline. It did not seem like that.
I think that's also great writers, great scene partners, great directors. It's a team effort, you know, so we all see from different perspectives and we all have input and we all work together to create the best possible, you know, story. So I think it came from everybody putting all their input and perspectives together.
Now, I know soaps now have very limited rehearsal times.
Yes.
Did you have more of that also back then? Or because that was sort of at the fairly current, but not now.
Yeah. And not that much, because it's daytime. I mean, daytime has to move fast, but a little bit more than what it is now, But now it's even quicker and quicker.
And when you say quicker and quicker,
you know, if you could do it on one, maybe two takes, it would be great.
Okay, that's quick.
Yeah.
That's quick.
Yeah.
Now, I was curious, because I know you're very expressive when you perform, and your expressions come across really well on camera, but I would imagine it would be great on stage too. Have you done any stage work at this point?
I did a performance on a small stage, A Flea in Her Ear, which is a French farce, and it was so much fun.
So you liked it?
Okay. Yeah, I did. I did like it. But it's a whole different experience. I mean, it's instant gratification, obviously. But and there's beauty in that, and there's beauty of the flow of constantly going nonstop to the end. But there's also sometimes the beauty of going, can I do that again? You know, where on stage you can't say that.
That's right. You can.
You just have to keep going. So. It's interesting. I mean, it's interesting to have, the different perspective.
So. Is that something you'd like to try again at some point, or are you more comfortable with the screen?
I think it depends on the play. Again, the French Forest was so much fun, fun. And you do bond as a family because you're together much like daytime. It depends on the play.
Okay. Now, you then went on and you did Summer on Days of Our Lives.
Yes.
But you were first Brie.
Yes. Dark hair Brie, blonde hair Summer.
Now, did a lot of people contact you, I mean, especially through the social media world, because everything is instant?
Yes.
Asking you about that, like saying, weren't you just on that show? And we're asking, did you play Brie, or did people immediately leave that and suspend reality and just go with it?
Well, a lot of people didn't recognize me with my different hair color.
Really?
So they were like, she looks familiar, but we don't. And then
That's really funny.
And they're like, oh yeah. So it's amazing how physical differences throw people off a little bit. And there was enough time between Brie and Summer.
Well, that's true. Brie and Summer were not the same, you know, like not 2 months apart.
Yeah. And Brie didn't really have that strong of a storyline, so it wasn't, you know, something that left too much of an imprint in people's minds. So.
And it's interesting because Brie actually ultimately at the end of someone else's storyline, you know, at the end of another storyline, did ultimately have an impact in people's minds. At the end, thinking back to him, so that was sort of amusing.
Yeah, that was interesting.
It came full circle ultimately, uh-huh. And I know that we sort of miss you. We do miss you. I miss you on Days. I really do. I thought Summer had a whole lot more story to tell.
Outside of the story that she was given at that time. And her relationship with her mom, I think, can go so many different directions and so deep. And I love working with Suzanne.
I was going to say, how is that working with Suzanne Rogers?
Oh my God, love her. She gives her all, so.
Days called and said, got a new story, we want Summer back.
Would I have to go blonde again?
Well, there's hair dye. Summer could have really gotten into that hair dye bottle.
I was into brunette, remember, near the end of the storyline. So maybe I show up.
That's right. She could show up back to brunette.
I could show up back to brunette.
And there she goes, new personality, new
exactly.
hair, right?
Anything goes.
I mean, you know, we know Brady's going to be left in the dirt soon, so...
I love working on this.
Okay,
definitely.
So, you know, you still see daytime as options there.
Oh my God, I've always had great experiences on daytime. So, I wouldn't close the door on that opportunity. And everybody's so cool there. So.
And now we talked about Port Charles.
Yes.
And General Hospital adjacent to Port Charles.
Mm-hmm.
And Days and As the World Turns.
Yes.
I'm going to try this, see if we can get you your either most favorite or most challenging storyline amongst those.
Among all three?
Among all three. Is there like something that stands out like, oh my God, I love this so much, I can't believe it, I wish I could do something like it again, that kind of a moment.
Oh my God, there have been so many great storylines.
There were.
How do you pick just one?
Think about it a second, because I mean, I know, like, I've watched all three. Yes, I'm such a soap junkie.
I don't know. Is there one you like? I liked all of them, because there were so many different ones, and it just took me on a roller coaster ride, you know, and it was fun. I think the, and again, I can't pick just one.
You don't have to pick just one, you can pick
but,
a couple,
but,
that's fine.
But I think the Port Charles, when Karen was addicted to drugs and had that whole drug issue and extracurricular job issues.
Oops.
That was fun. Time in a Bottle, going back in time with Jay Pickett, doing that was kind of fun, dressing up like that. The baby kidnapping storyline on As the World Turns was fun. There were so many.
I mean, on As the World Turns, also the fantasizing of relationships. that were not to meant to be.
Yes. Which one?
they got, which was kind of neat, they got dark, but in this sort of amusing, creative, creepy kind of way.
I know, it was fun. It was fun. And then dressing up whenever we did those fun storylines, you know, when you dress up as Beauty and the Beast or whatever.
Right.
That was always fun to do. Just too many to pick from. It was just fun.
Now, when you've been on both soaps, as a matter of fact, both the latter ones, you were parts of very, very poor families.
Yes.
Did you do any research at all to figure out where you were supposed to be in those families? Now, I know for Summers, probably a little less, because she didn't know where she was.
Yeah.
Okay.
But when I found out that Maggie Kiriakis was my mom, I need, because that kind of affects me a little bit, and like you said, yeah, I didn't have that much of a background, so I just did it pretty, you know, roughly. But with Kathleen Widows, who is also amazing.
Oh my gosh.
Beautiful, beautiful woman. And my first scene was with her, so she just totally made everything just smooth and flowing. I did tons of research for her, because, you know, they come from a farm and they had that whole big, strong family bond. So
yeah, they were really the core family of As the World Turns in so many ways. I mean, I know there were other families in it, but that was the family.
That was the family. So that was a lot more research that I did for that than with Maggie. Because I still wanted to be, you know, a little not knowing, because Summer didn't know. So I just wanted to keep that authenticity.
In all the things you've done, what was your favorite? Favorite character to play? Favorite character to play?
I would say Summer was my favorite so far, because she had so many issues to deal with, and she was bipolar, and she didn't know where she came from, and she had that lost soul kind of feeling, so it was a lot of deep work I had to research, and most challenging for me. But Meg was also fun, but it was more cut and dry of where she came from. Where Summer, you had to, there are a lot of levels to Summer. So yeah.
And now, I know you worked on Ladies of the Lake.
Yes.
The web series.
Yes.
Are we going to get to see that at some point?
I hope so.
I mean,
I
personally have followed all the photos for it.
Yes.
And there's clearly a mystery involved
in
it.
Yes, there is a mystery.
so it's still like in the works to hopefully get out there.
It's still in the works to hopefully get out there. I will keep you posted.
Please.
As soon as I know, you'll know. But
I'm a mystery lover. I love to be able to untangle what's tangled up.
Yes, and Martha Madison was in it, Lily Melgar, Jessica Morrison,
it's an all-star.
Yeah, I mean, it's...
And for those people who are daytime fans, that's like, would be the web series to watch also.
Oh my God, so much fun.
And you participated in The Bay as well.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, a long time ago, it was Far From the Bay, and I played Christo's mom.
Okay.
We'll see that was way back then.
Okay, so is that a tease? Okay, I'm just saying, put it out there. Okay. And then I saw that you had a film that's now, I guess, in post-production. Is that true?
I did a short film called Say You Will.
Okay.
And that's being edited right now, so we'll wait to see what happens with that.
Okay, is that like a festival-bound piece, you think?
Yes, it is. And then I have another project coming up in January, so...
Okay. More mysteries to untangle. Stay tuned for the next.
Part two.
Hey, I'm good on that. Don't threaten me. I'm okay with that, don't threaten me. So those are the new projects now, so you're thinking you're talking about something in January, so that's what we're going to hear about at some point, correct?
At some point.
Okay. And now, I have to tell you, you're busy late. You are very busy.
It's
really, which is great.
Yeah.
how do you balance personal life, family life, with all that you're doing? Because you're out there, you're doing the web series, you were doing, you were on daytime, which is every single day. It's not, you know, an episode a week.
I think my key magic word is being organized, because when I'm organized and I have everything in order and a schedule, it just doesn't waste my time, and it frees up a lot of my time to do more stuff that I need to do.
So are you old school schedule or new school schedule? Like, do you like I'm on the phone and I got that calendar and I got reminders beeping at me? And
I have both. I have both.
Because
I still need a pencil and paper, and I need to smell the paper. but this is convenient too when you're in the car and you're just pulled over and looking through the scrolling, and I have both, and as many reminders as possible.
Now, you're doing a lot with fans lately. I mean, you really are. It's wonderful. I mean, you and I met at a fan event.
I know, isn't that
which is kind of cool. I love that.
I love that too.
And now I've got getting to sit with you and interview you, which is also cool for me, actually. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
But you're doing more fan events. I know you're stopping in on Saturday night at AfterBuzz TV and greeting fans. And then on Sunday you have another event.
I know, with Jen and Martha and Trika. And
a whole ladies' brunch that gives a whole nanny to a ladies' brunch. Hello. Ladies' brunch on steroids. We like that.
It's going to be fun.
But, I mean, I see you doing so much with fans and for fans.
Well, what
is your why?
I think you guys are so supportive, and that's like, it keeps us going, and we appreciate that. So, you know, it's my way of thanking them and being there.
I think that shines through also, I have to say. I think that's why you have so many fans, is people can see that this is a nice person. This is a person we want to support.
Thank you.
And for my own part, I want Summer to come back and have a whole different storyline and get to know her sisters.
I know.
Hello.
I know. I have so many relationships.
she's got a bigger family than she's been given permission to meet so far, so we want her to get to meet them all.
Well, maybe Eric will come and find me again. I'll be at the beach again. You're here again.
As in Eric, when we say Eric, you mean Brady.
Yes, Brady. Sorry, I'm sorry.
That's okay. Because actually, I think the Eric character will be coming back soon, too. So I just want everybody to get all mixed
up. Oh, sorry. Yes, sorry. I should stick with character. Well,
that's
Brady.
Well, that's okay. Because we all know Eric Martzoff plays Brady, so that's cool.
Yeah.
But he's also a generous fan person, so it's awesome. Funny, because it shows in people's work too that they're people you want to meet in person.
He's a great guy.
Well, I want to thank you for sitting and meeting with me.
Yay!
This was great. My first trip to LA since my honeymoon.
Woo!
And we don't want to know how many decades ago that was, folks.
Just a few years ago.
Yeah, my 30-year-old daughter will explain that later.
Like, Mom.
But thank you so much.
Thank you,
it was great.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.